Hello students, welcome to the session on the Stern and Gerlach experiment. So this is in Atomic Physics, Paper 5, Unit 1. So in the last session, we have already discussed about the Stern and Gerlach experiment, the introduction, the principle and theory of this experiment, and also the most important significance. The experiment was performed by Stern and Gerlach, which proved beyond doubt the existence of magnetic moments of atoms and their space quantization in support of vector atom model of the nucleus. So we have discussed the principle and theory of this experiment. Now today we'll discuss about the experimental procedure and the results and the inference of this experiment. So on the basis of the theory, we have seen that the displacement of the atomic magnets is given by this expression. S is equal to half dB by dx mu by m L square by V square with usual notations. And knowing the value of dB by dx, the magnetic field gradient, L, the length of or the distance of travel of the atomic magnets in the field, V, the velocity of the atomic magnets, the magnetic moment of the electrons, mu can be calculated. This is what we have discussed in the last session. Today we'll discuss about the experimental arrangement and the procedure part of this experiment. So to start with, the silver is boiled in an oven. Atoms of silver stream out from the opening in the oven, and this beam of silver atoms is obtained in the form of a collimated beam using the two slits S1 and S2, so that a sharp linear beam of atoms is obtained. These atoms then are passed through a very inhomogeneous magnetic field between the special shaped poles of a magnet MM. A high degree of non-uniformity in the magnetic field is produced by making one of the pole pieces of a powerful electromagnet a knife edge shape and the other flat with groove cut in the opposite to the knife edge. You can see the diagram here. This is the shape of the magnet. These are the two pole pieces. This is the knife edge shaped pole piece. This is flat with a groove. So this is the shape of the pole pieces to produce inhomogeneous magnetic field in the path of the atomic beam. So this is the oven. Here the silver atoms are boiled. So we'll get a beam of silver atoms here, and they are passed through two slits. S1 and S2 are the two slits, so that you will get a beam which is very much collimated, a straight line path for the atomic beam of silver. And then these are the pole pieces of the magnet. So in this region, the silver atoms are influenced by the magnetic field, that too non-uniform magnetic field. And this is the screen on which these silver atoms fall. So this is the nature of the magnetic field lines. This is one pole, which is a knife edge shape. The other one is a groove shaped pole piece. So in between them, we have got a non-uniform, inhomogeneous magnetic field. So it is strong here and weak here. So this is the experimental arrangement. So this is what we have mentioned here, high degree of non-uniformity in the magnetic field. And it is obtained by having a non-uniform type of shape for the pole pieces. One is knife edge shape, the other one is a flat end with a groove. The lines of force are close together at the knife edge and much stronger than at the other pole piece. The magnetic field is at right angles to the direction of movement of the atoms. Initially, say the direction of motion of the magnetic atomic magnet is in the positive x direction, and the magnetic field is in the vertical direction, that may be taken as the z direction. The whole arrangement is enclosed in an evacuated chamber. So this is what we have discussed, the experimental arrangement, the shape of the pole piece of the electromagnet. This is the shape of the magnetic field lines. Now, I will come to this later. This is the shape of the image formed on the screen. In the absence of the magnetic field, only one line is formed when a magnetic field, that non-uniform magnetic field is applied, two images are formed, one by the side of the other. So this is the experimental arrangement, a photo of experimental arrangement. We'll once again discuss this. This is the oven to produce silver atoms. This is the beam of silver atoms. So these are the two slits, just to have a collimated beam of silver atoms. So these are the two pole pieces of magnet, south pole, north pole. So this is the knife-edged shape of the magnet. This is groove-shaped. So this is the screen. So atomic beam will travel like this. So it is influenced by the non-uniform magnetic field, and it will fall onto the screen. Now let us discuss what happens and how it happens and what is the cause or the reason behind this type of effect or result. So this is the same experimental arrangement, another picture. We'll go to the next slide. So the result of this experiment: with no field, the beam produces a narrow continuous line on the plate. Say this is the image in the absence of the field. Now, on applying inhomogeneous magnetic field, that is what I have just mentioned, when it is allowed to pass through such a kind of non-uniform magnetic field, it was found that the stream of silver atoms splits into two, producing two separate lines on the plate. So this is the result. This is a single line in the absence of the magnetic field. These are the two lines in the presence of non-uniform magnetic field. This is actually the result, observed result in the Stern-Gerlach experiment. This splitting up of the beam into two parts of approximately equal intensity was actually observed in this experiment. This is the photograph of that particular screen of Stern-Gerlach experiment. You can observe here two split images, two images formed as a result of splitting up of atomic beam. So you know, this is quite obvious. When the atomic beam reaches the screen, it produces an image. So that's how the image was obtained there. In terms of the vector atom model, those atoms with electron spins directed parallel to the magnetic field will experience a force in one direction, whereas those with oppositely directed spins will experience a force in the opposite direction. It was found that each silver atom had a magnetic moment of one Bohr magneton in the direction of the field. So this is another photograph of Stern-Gerlach experiment with well resolving power spectrometer. If you observe, you will get images like this. So these are the two images, no post selection, with post selection. This is without a magnetic field, this is with the non-uniform magnetic field. Now let us discuss the theory of this experiment. Why there is a splitting up of the atomic beam in presence of non-uniform magnetic field? We have to explain this. This can be explained only on the basis of vector atom model, or the idea of space quantization, or the magnetic moment of the electron. So this is the atomic structure of silver, there are 47 electrons in the extranuclear part of the silver atom. This is the nucleus, these are the electrons, and the electronic configuration is like this, 2, 8, 18, 18, and 1. So in the 5s state, we have got electrons, and there is one electron. So the outermost electron is in the 5s state. So this is 5s, one electron. So all the optical and the spectral properties of this silver atom is due to this electron, which is called optical electron or the spectral electron. This contributes to the optical or spectral behavior of the silver. Now let us see the state of this electron. So this electron is in the 5s state. So this is same diagram. So there are two possible spins for this electron, spin up and spin down. So in the 5s state electrons, those with spin up will move in this direction, spin down will move in this direction. So they are separated out into two separate beams and image is formed at two different positions. So this is plus half spin, this is minus half. So this is the reason why the atomic beam of silver is split into two components, because of spin. Or this is an evidence for electron spin hypothesis according to vector atom model. In addition to this, we can discuss it in on the basis of magnetic moment also. So the inference of this experiment for S state, L is equal to 0. So electron is in the S state, 5s electron is there in the outermost orbit, for which L equal to 0, the orbital angular momentum of the electron is 0. The entire magnetic moment is due to the spin of the electron. So accordingly, the atomic beam splits into two, one with the electron spin plus half and with a minus half another beam. So with plus half, you will get one beam and one image. With minus half spin, we will get another beam and another image. And once again, since J equal to 2, J is equal to L plus S, but L is equal to 0, S is equal to half, so J value is half. In the present case, there are 2J plus 1. J equal to half gives you MJ is equal to 2, and two values for MJ in the magnetic field. Hence, the beam splits into two accordingly. Since you have two MJ values, the electrons with one particular MJ value will be separated into one beam, and another value of MJ, they are separated into another. So we get two beams separately. Accordingly, we get two images. So this experiment confirms the concept of electron spin and the space quantization of the vector atom model. So this is a confirmative experiment to prove the spatial quantization and electron spin hypothesis. So this is about Stern-Gerlach experiment, which is an evidence for the vector atom model, especially the electron spin hypothesis and spatial quantization of electron orbits. Thank you.